There's a dark history to this area that's not widely known, for this spot is the original home of the word bedlam. On this site in the 13th century, the first ever psychiatric hospital in England, St. Mary of Bethlehem, was built. The reputation the hospital gained for its residents' wild and crazy behavior spread so far and wide that even today we use the word bedlam to describe scenes of uproar and confusion. There is little information that exists today about the hospital when it stood here, but there are snippets of eyewitness accounts that have survived, like this one, noted by Donald Lupton from around 1630. "Seems strange that anyone should recover here. The cryings, the screechings, roarings, brawlings, shaking of chains, swearings, frettings, chafings are so many, so hideous, so great, that they are more able to drive a man to have his wits rather than out of them, and to help one that had never had them, or have lost them, to find them again." Although Bethlehem Hospital left this site in 1675, sometimes when I hear these descriptions and then I look around at what stands in its place today, I can't help but wonder if there is still some trace of bedlam lingering in the air.
TV, the one you take to bed with you.
No! しさに魅せられて、クリオの女神は。
ことがある。いろんなことがある。いろんなことがある。
Thank you. used to be clearer in my attitudes towards what we call mental illness. Now, I don't know. I used to think a diagnosis was really, really useful. It was tangible, you could grasp it, you could either challenge it or disagree with it or accept it. And it made sense of an experience that other people didn't have. And now, I almost reject diagnosis because it feels like it defines you, and it defines you according to other people's values, and it can label you as a victim. You can almost conform to the stereotype of being a patient and what's expected of you. You know, for the first time all my life, you know, it's now 27 years since I first came to mental health services, and I never accepted I was a mental health patient, if you like, according to the stereotype. And now, you know, the people around me are wonderful, who come and help me, but now I have no choice but people. If my nurse wants to come to my home, she's got the right to. I can't refuse it. And it's not that I'm different, I just feel like a patient. I feel diminished. And part of feeling diminished means that I want to reject what they're saying about me. But also, I do really struggle with my beliefs. They've never completely gone away since I was out of hospital this time, so feelings of evil are quite strong in me, but I'm very contradictory. I talk about spirits and evil and devils inside me, and yet I'm an atheist, so it doesn't make any sense. But I don't like to dismiss, even if it's true that my beliefs are caused by illness, I think there are lots of ways of seeing reality. And in a different world, we might not call it illness, we might just call it a different way of perceiving the world. And I don't think illness is just a tangible thing. Illness is defined according to our society's judgment about what is right, what is this and that, what is ill and what is healthy.
Are they afraid that you might hurt them?
Yep.
Would you, Beth?
Mm-hmm.
When would you do it?
Nighttime.
Okay. Why would you do nighttime?
Because I don't like them seeing me do it. But they can tell me to.